Welcome to Daily Zohar. Before I would start, I would like to give a shout out to our dear friend Barbara, who sent me yesterday the most encouraging, nicest email most likely I ever got in my life. So thank you. It was really unbelievable. I was humbled. The Zohar says, come and see. כל אשר תמצא ידך לעשות בכוחך, עשה. Whatever is in your power to do, do. That's already a statement that we can write a book on just by that. זהו שהאדם, what does it mean? שהאדם צריך לכלול השמאל בימין, to include the left with the right. וכל מה שהוא עושה, and everything that he does, צריך שלא יהיו אלא כלולים בימין. It needs to be generated, first of all, by the right side. It reminds me, years ago, many years ago, I read a book by Carlos Castaneda, where he instructed his Don Juan, his magician, tells his student to do everything with the left, not with the right. And for me it was like, wow, we just do the opposite. So he said, the Zohar says, everything you should do should include, should come and be generated from the right. The right represents koach, your ability to do action. The right corresponds with the chesed, with rachamim, with mercy, with kindness. That's why magicians, a.k.a. Carlos Castaneda and company, do everything from the left side. Want to bring the din, they want to bring lekovka, and so on, without getting into this, but I'm sure you get the idea. Kol asher, and how much you do it? Kol asher timtza yadcha. It says, kol asher timtza yadcha, whatever your hand would reach, Yadcha means that's small. La'asot bekochacha, to do with your action. Koach, might. That's the yamin. Yadcha, your right, is your left. Your koach, the power, means your right. So therefore you're including the left with the right. You're bringing everything in into its right path. Ve'kevan she'adam nizhar, since a person is careful, שכל מעשיו יהיו לצד ימין ויכללו השמאל, since you are careful to do everything you do with the ימין, with the right side, which again is a matter of kindness and mercy and everything that comes along with that and represents your own ability to do things and including the left with the right, אז הקדוש ברוך הוא שורה בתוכו בעולם הזה, then הקדוש ברוך הוא would dwell inside of you in this world, or he would be accompanying you in this world in anything that you do. Ve'yasof oto elav, and they will gather that man to him ba'olam haba, in the world to come. Ve'al yomar adam, and a person should not say, at the time of which I'll come to that world, then I'm going to ask HaKadosh Baruch Hu for mercy. Then I'm going to do tshuva. Then I'm going to repent. Then I'm going to fix my ways. That's not going to happen. Ela ki en ma'ase v'cheshbon v'dat v'chokhma achar shi'istalek ha'adam min ha'olam hazeh. What does that mean? That there is no cheshbon. Cheshbon is that you give the total, right? Cheshbon is you give the total. Vedat, knowledge, or wisdom, and chokhmah, knowledge, after you depart from this world. Ela, im adam rotze she'amelech ya'ir lo la'olam ahu, if you want that HaKadosh Baruch Hu would light your ways in that world, ויתן לו חלק לעולם הבא, and will give you a portion to the world to come. We say Kol Yisrael yesh lahem chelek la'olam haba. Every Jew has its portion to the world to come. But that is not given to you automatically. You got to work for it. You have a portion, but you got to earn it. Ya'asok, so therefore if you want a portion to the world to come, ya'asok ba'olam hazeh. Do everything that you can that is within your power in this world, generated by the right and including the left. In other words, don't neglect the left, but everything should be generated by the right. Everything should be generated. That's why people are very careful not to make a bracha with the left hand. You know, people want to do the bracha with the right hand, and so on and so forth. So a lot of different things like this. That's why when we put our shoes on in the morning, right? Beyond the halakha, there is a reason to that. You put your right foot on, your right shoe on, you put your left, you tie them left, and then you tie right, because you're including the left with the right. And then, not only you do that, it's not only enough to include and to do all your actions with the right, including the left, in this world. It's not enough. But, v'yu kol ma'asav l'shem HaKadosh Baruch Hu. Because all your actions should be geared towards God. In other words, when a person gets up in the morning, he should say to himself, what does HaKadosh Baruch Hu want for me today? What does he want for me today? Not, you know, when you're 80 years old, HaKadosh Baruch Hu wanted, or what's the, what does HaKadosh Baruch Hu want for me today? What am I expected to do? It's like when you come to the office in the morning, you come to your job in the morning. Okay, right away, what do you need to do? So sometimes we'll have a meeting today, we have to do this, we take care of this, and so on and so forth. Everybody gets his share. So a person needs to ask himself, what does HaKadosh Baruch Hu want for me today? What's my job? What am I supposed to do today? And sometimes you're going to be in situations. And the situations are going to be challenging. And then you need to ask yourself, what does HaKadosh Baruch Hu want me to do in this situation? Not in a complaint matter. Well, like, what does HaKadosh Baruch Hu want for me? Why? Well, you know, no. What would be an appropriate way for me to deal with this situation that will be appropriate towards HaKadosh Baruch Hu? Somebody said something not nice to you. What does HaKadosh Baruch Hu want me to do? If I would ask HaKadosh Baruch Hu what to do, what would he tell me to do? In other words, HaKadosh Baruch Hu is like your mentor. He's like your Rebbe. Not your cult leader, God forbid. Cult leader tells you what to do. You do this. You don't even ask the question. Here you're asking the question. He says, what should I be doing? It's a difference, right, David? And the HaKadosh Baruch Hu would say to you, and you would answer yourself, well, I don't think HaKadosh Baruch Hu wants me to have a fight. It'll be machloket. It's going to be... So I'll be kind to the person. You know, I won't say anything. Yet, I need to include the left with it. There's going to be a din. In other words, even my kindness needs to have a certain limit to it. But even the din, the judgment, has to be with kindness. Din means also to put a line. If you're going to be extremely kind and overly generous, you'll get what they have in Scandinavia today. They let everybody in and now they're burning the place. You can't have that. Your argument's sake, let's say, if you're talking about, let's say, immigration, it's not a problem. You want to come to this country? It's not a problem. This country welcomes you. Come on, come to the country. But there are laws here of how you're going to come. You cannot be a criminal, you can have a, I don't know, terrorist connections, and so on and so forth. You can become automatically a dependent on the, it's not a social That's why socialism, in a way, it's good. It's all good. It's bad. Why? Because there's no din involved with it. You can't be completely capitalist either. You have to have also that put into boundaries. You have to somewhere in between. So you want to come to this country? That's fine. It's not a problem. Chavot, come. Please, join us. Let's clear the slate, and then you go ahead and do what you need to do. But you can't just come in and, you know, you want to go, not a problem, come in. We don't care who you are, what you are. You know, just coming by. Michael, by the way, you have some stuff to do over there. So then we'll give you, you don't have to work, we'll give you Social Security, we'll give you Medicaid, we'll give you apartments, the government pay. Then what will happen is like overly kind, and then they'll burn the house down. There's a limit. You have to be kind to the limit. If somebody says, listen, you know, can I stay in your house for a day? Okay, yeah, you know, I know you're a nice guy. I'm not going to let anybody in my house. I don't let a stranger from the street live in my house. Remember like a few years ago, where was it, Utah or something? Right? I won't let somebody in my house. Or somebody, I'm like, yeah, sure, a guest. Or my neighbor would say to me, you know, I have, I don't know, my daughter's getting married, so the guy needs to stay. Can he stay in your house? I said, sure. He recommends. I know him. But how long is he going to be staying? 2 days? A night? A week? After a week, he's, wait, Habibi, you know, take your time. This is not a hotel. It's not Motel 6 here. Boundaries. Including the left with the right means also defining the boundaries. Clearing out, not limiting us, but rather making us free. How? When I know what the where the boundaries are, I can concentrate on the task ahead of me. When I don't know where the boundaries are, I need to figure out all the time what to do. You want to make more noise there? I can figure out what to do. If I don't know what I'm doing, I need to worry. Should I be doing this? Should I be doing that? I become immobile. So, and that's the concept behind halakha. People have it wrong. People think that halakha, the mitzvot that we have, is to control people. The rabbis, God, whoever they will be, make those things to control the people. No, it's to make them free. Don't worry about how you're going to put your shoes. I'll tell you how to do it. Concentrate on the task ahead of you. Get rid of all these shenanigans. Defy the boundaries and go. How fast can I go on, let's say, autobahn? Or on a highway? Just how fast does the car go? Not fast you can go. How fast does your car go? Why? Because it's well defined. It's straight. Here are the roads. There are the guardrails here. And I can just put the pedal to the metal. How fast can you go on a 4x4 track, off-road? You can't. Sometimes you go a quarter of a mile an hour because there are terrains and you have to go like this. You can't go fast. If I need to cover ground, yes, 4x4 is fun. Don't get me wrong, but I can't go fast. So what is the task ahead of me? That defining the laws, even going on a off-road, there are the laws, there are the boundaries of what you can do, what you cannot do. You need to stay loyal to those boundaries, then you'll be free to execute your task. Things don't get done because you don't know your boundaries. That's why. When you see that one thing after the other, you can't accomplish it. Not because of lack of effort. Just, I don't know, I start something, cannot finish. Because you haven't defined your boundaries. You want to get there, but you haven't defined the boundaries. So that's why nothing gets done. You didn't set consequences. Listen, if you're going to go too close to the guardrail, you need to turn. You're gonna finish the turn. You're gonna fall. It's not gonna happen to you. There are laws. Not to restrict you, to free you. It sounds like a paradox. The problem is that we became so obsessed with laws that in the end that becomes the you know, we make more laws and more laws and more laws and so on and so forth. What are the boundaries? What are the rules? If you have a driver and then somebody else is doing shotgun, right? Sitting right next to him, he's the navigator. Everybody knows he's going to look at a map, he's going to drive. Then they can switch. But when they decide to switch. But if the guy who's reading the map will also move the wheel, what's going to happen? They're going to flip. Or the guy who is driving, if he says, excuse me, let me see the map 1 second. They're going to flip. So the defining roles is also having boundaries. So if you have a society that nothing gets done, there are no boundaries. You can do whatever you want. It's like an anarchy. Or sometimes it's too many rules. You got to think about it. So everything is, it is what it is. But it's your attitude and your outlook on things that makes things positive or negative. Things are things. You know what this is? This is this. This is a telephone. It's nothing else. But what you're going to do with it, how you're going to relate to it, is going to make it. It could be an item to throw, or it could be something to communicate, or somebody to curse, or to do. It's what you decide to do with it, that's what it becomes. And you decide if this just becomes, this is a telephone for you to connect, or this becomes your master. It doesn't change what it is. What changes is what you make out of it. Hey, Shalom. Now, when we're talking about Din v'cheshbon, it's something that we need to relate also. And we said it before. For example, the Gra says, the Gaon Mivilna said on the word Din v'cheshbon. It doesn't make sense. What does it mean? I'm going to a store. I'm entering a grocery store, a supermarket. First of all, they tell me, all right, what did we have here? We had this, we had this, we had this, we had this, we had this. $100. Okay, $100. Here we go. Swipe the card. $100. There's the cheshbon, right? This, and then we have the din. How much should I pay? Here is, first of all, the din, then the cheshbon. It's reverse. Why? Because what happens when a person dies, we live our life in a dimension of time as well. And we don't see the progression of getting from this point to this point in a matter of a split of a second. So we progress through the things, but we are moving in the dimension of time. We're moving, it's a dimension. If I would walk from this side of the room to that side of the room, I'm moving in one in one dimension. If I'm going to move sideways, I'm walking in a different direction. If I'll jump and so on and so forth, time is a dimension as well. When a person dies, and he goes to the other world, there's no time there. Because that spiritual world is above time. There's no time there. So therefore what happens is, everything is revealed to you in a split of a second. It's like a boom, like this, of your life. All this information that was stored throughout the span of the years of your life, all this information is all of a sudden being accessed immediately in a split of a second. It would be like if the computer would open every single file that is on it in one instant. The computer which will crush. In order to prevent that, we have about 90% of our brains blocking this excess information. Everything that we had experienced is stored in our mind. Every single thing. Everything I touched in any moment of my life since I was born, and maybe even beforehand. Everything I smelled. Everything I saw. Everything I heard. Anything I said, it's all been stored right here in this box. My mind, my brain, works very hard to make it not accessible, because what will happen is I'll be overwhelmed. When you're dead, there's no need for it. Boom! In a split of a second. Then they're going to ask you, what is this person? What is this person? Tzaddik? or rasha, good or bad. All of a sudden, every decision that you made in your life, every kind word, every nasty word, any sarcastic word, every encouraging word, everything comes out, and then it's going to be here or here. And that's what we want to know. There's no here, here or here. And you're going to say, tzaddik. Okay, tzaddik, okay. Now let's see why you're tzaddik. You said rasha. Okay, let's see why you're rasha. This is the din. First of all, you said the din. What is this person? And that you're saying about yourself. What is this person? Tzaddik or rasha? So okay, that thing is you. Now let's see exactly what happened here. And then we do the cheshbon. You did this, you did that. You did this, you did that. Cheshbon that we do with you is also what the Gra says, is we make the cheshbon. Okay, you did a mitzvah, terrific. You did an avera, you did a sin, you did something wrong. Okay, not a problem. How long did it take you to do that? Oh, 5 seconds, right? The usual 5 seconds. 5 seconds. In the 5 seconds that you just did, or 5 minutes, or whatever it is that you did, you could have done so many other things that were on your plate, but you chose to do that. For example, you had an hour, you had 2 hours of free time. You can make a decision to come here and learn. Or you made a decision. I don't know. To smoke pot. Or, God forbid, to watch porn. Okay, so you did the avera. Okay, now get a whacking. Right? But now we're going to do the cheshbon with you. At the time that you did this, this 2 hours, you could have come to yeshiva and learned X amount of pages of Gemara, X amount of halachot, because that's what they did that day in yeshiva, X amount of words, X amount of vowels. So not only you get punished for what you did, they're going to figure out what you could have done and did it. And that is the cheshbon that they do with you. You need to be aware. Now, if you're directing your... And by the way, I'm going to tell you the following. Let's say you came to yeshiva, you came to learn Torah for half an hour. You think you get a sachar, you think you get a reward for only half an hour? You are wrong. How long did it take you to come here? When you made that decision, how do I know it? Based on the Meraglim, it doesn't make sense. I mean, they went 40 days in Israel, and then you're going to get 40 years. How long did they do the Avera? How long did it tell them to say, guys, you know, this is a bad place we're going, Eretz Ocholet Yoshvea, this is a bad place. Okay, so they gave a speech for 5 minutes. They gave us half an hour. They were standing there in front of everybody. Okay, so half an hour. So give us half a year. When did you come up with 40 days? They didn't do the Avera for 40 days. You're wrong. Because for 40 days they were thinking, why we are not going, how we come, what are we going to do not to go into here, not to go into the land? What are we going to do not to go into the land? So that's the cheshbon that they did. For 40 days you were making that cheshbon. So 40 days you got... These are 40 years. So when you made your plan to come here to learn, from the moment that you said, I'm going to come to learn, this is being counted to you as a mitzvah, hamitasek ba mitzvah. It's like you are dealing with a mitzvah. So let's say, for example, you get up in the morning and you made a plan, I'm going to come to yeshiva at 10 o'clock. Okay, why not 9? But never mind, but 10 o'clock. You made that decision at 8 o'clock. It's being considered to you as you get a reward for all these 2 hours, even though you came here for half an hour. So you get 2.5 hours of sachar, of reward, but lehavdil the other way around. When you do an avera, oh, I'm going to go watch this pornography movie. Where is it? The show is at 5 o'clock. All right, I have 3 hours. Ooh, I can't wait. You get not only a avera for watching the dirt. You don't get only an avera for the time that you watched it. You get also an avera for the time that you had started, initiated the plan to go there. This is ridiculous. And you call yourself good business people? That's like it's unbelievable. That's the din v'cheshbon. That's why it says you should direct your actions to HaKadosh Baruch Hu. What does HaKadosh Baruch Hu want for me today? What does HaKadosh Baruch Hu want me to do? Does HaKadosh Baruch Hu want me to cheat today? To steal? To rob? To lie? To be nasty? You think HaKadosh Baruch Hu wants me to be nasty today? I don't think HaKadosh Baruch Hu wants me to be nasty today. So if I ask myself, what does God want for me today? I tell you, there will be a lot of things I'm not going to be doing today that otherwise I would have done. And take that into account. You think God wants you to play basketball today? Or to watch them playing baseball? Really? God wants me to go to Shea Stadium to watch them play baseball? You gotta be kidding me. So you're gonna ask yourself, so why did he make why did God allow to build Shea Stadium? No, sorry, it was a city field. See, I'm old, I'm ancient, I'm an old geezer. So why did God allow them to make Citi Field or Yankee Stadium? He allowed it, but it's not for me. That's not what he wants me to do. It's for other people. That's his cheshbon. When I go up there, I ask him. But it's not meant for me, because I know it's not meant for me, because I know inside what I need to do. You think God wants me to be a wicked man today? You think God wants me to be sad today? You think God wants me to be sad today? You think God wants me to be upset today? No, He doesn't. He wants me to be happy. So if I see things and I'm not happy, what's wrong with who? With God? No, what's wrong with me? Then you need to ask yourself, let's say you are sad today. What's wrong with me? Why am I sad? You think God wants me to be sad? No, He doesn't want me to be sad. So what's wrong with me? Let me fix me. What's the underlining? If somebody tells you something, it's not just the word. It's the reason behind what he's telling you. So if HaKadosh Baruch Hu tells you, Ve'ahavta et Hashem Elokecha b'chol levavcha, b'chol nafshecha, b'chol me'odecha, you should love God with all your power, with all your might, and everything that you have. Why is he telling me that? Tremendous thing. Why does not, you would not find in the Torah one commandment to hate? But God forgot to put it in? For you to answer. And that's the din v'cheshbon. Because if you direct all your actions to HaKadosh Baruch Hu, when a person comes to the din and he goes to the place called Gehenam. Gehenam, by the way, is not what people think. It's not like Dante's scene of hell with like demons flying and fire. It's a volcano. Something much, much different than that. But you should know that in as much as there are levels in Shamayim, there's also levels in Gehenam. And I don't like to use the word hell for Gehenna. It's not, because hell comes out at a certain, almost like middle-aged Christian type of what hell is, and this is not what Gehenna is. Don't confuse it. It got so rooted into us, really trying to do my best not to use this term, so I'll use the word Gehenna. That's where the din is being done. Over there, there's no advice, there's no wisdom, there's nothing you can do to be saved. No tricks, no loopholes to be saved from the din. Over there, whatever happens, happens. Whatever you did, you did. It's all out. Oh, there's a loophole. You know, I'll get a head there. I'll get find a loophole to get it. No, that doesn't happen. And then, Amadova Tachton, the lower, is called Sheol. Lower than that is Avdan. And near it, right? And it's one next to the other. Sheol and Ovdan. Umi sheyored le-Sheol, whoever goes down to Sheol, it's called Sheol Tachtiya, Sheol, yadunu oto. They're going to have the din. It's going to so-called service sentence, whatever happened. And from there, metzavtzef ve'ole, from there he's going to, after he's finished with this, he's going to fly up like a bird, you know, and elevate himself up. Now you're done, you can go out there. That's what it says. Morit Sha'ol Vayal. You go down to Sheol, and then you're going to come up. There is a way out of it. If you go to Ovdan, Le'abed means to get lost. So Ovdar is a place that you basically get lost. You have no battery? Okay. So a person that goes to Avdon does not come out of that eternally. And how is this? And what to save from that? To be able to be safe from that is to be every single day, is to do the din v'cheshbon, to ask yourself, what have I done wrong today? So you could repent it, so it doesn't become, every day before you go to bed, sit down and calculate to you in your mind, what have I done? Did I do anything wrong today? Not just chatanu, avinu, pashanu, and you go to bed. Think about it, sit down and think about it. Have yourself a little glass of something, say, what have I done today? Where did I mess up today? If you do that, you'll be able to fix that. If you won't be able to do that, you get accustomed to your habits, and then you're going to fall. And whoever is trying to, there's a person, it's called Baalei Cheshbon, whoever is trying to do that, Daat v'chokhmah, wisdom and good advice will come in his way, v'chama chamudot shorim bo, and it's going to be pleasant, and HaKadosh Baruch Hu likes these people, and at night he comes and he learns Torah with the souls who actually prepare themselves to greet him. So as they say, you need to prepare yourself one day to meet God, whether you like it or you don't like it, whether you believe it or not. Prepare yourself now so you'll know what to answer in the world to come.